In this video, we'll study about the branches from the trunk of the mandibular nerve. So, the branches from the trunk are two. The first one is the nervus spinosus or the meningeal branch, and the second one is the nerve to the medial pterygoid. So, the nervus spinosus is also known as the meningeal branch. It passes through the foramen spinosum along with the middle meningeal artery, and it supplies the dura mater of the middle cranial fossa. In this picture, you can see the nervus spinosus or the meningeal branch, which passes through the foramen spinosum along with the middle meningeal artery. So, this supplies the dura mater of the middle cranial fossa. The next branch from the trunk is the nerve to the medial pterygoid. So, this is a small branch which supplies the medial pterygoid muscle from its deeper surface, and it gives a few fibers which passes through the otic ganglia without interruption and supplies two other tensor muscles. One is the tensor valle palatinae muscle, the other one is the tensor tympani muscle. Next, we'll see what are the branches from the anterior division of the mandibular nerve in detail. The first nerve is the mesenteric nerve. The mesenteric nerve passes above the lateral pterygoid muscle and in front of the temporomandibular joint and behind the tendon of the temporalis muscle. The nerve emerges through the mandibular notch accompanied by the corresponding vessels and supplies the masseter muscle from its deeper surface. It also provides branches to the temporomandibular joint. The next branch are the deep temporal nerves. Usually they are two in number, anterior and the posterior deep temporal nerves. They ascend up deep to the upper border of the lateral pterygoid muscle and supplies the temporalis muscle from its deeper surface. The next nerve is the nerve to the lateral pterygoid. So, this nerve also passes deep to the lateral pterygoid muscle and supplies the lateral pterygoid muscle from its deeper surface. The next nerve is the buccal nerve. So, this is the only sensory branch from the anterior division of the mandibular nerve. So, this buccal nerve passes between the two heads of the lateral pterygoid muscle. Then it passes downwards and forward and emerges deep beneath the anterior border of the masseter muscle, and it supplies the skin and the mucous membrane of the cheek related to the buccinator muscle. The motor part of the mandibular nerve is tested clinically by asking the patient to clench his or her teeth and then feel for the contracting masseter and the temporalis muscle on two sides. If one masseter muscle is paralyzed, the jaw deviates to the paralyzed side on opening the mouth by the action of normal lateral pterygoid muscle of the opposite side. The activity of the pterygoid muscle is tested by asking the patient to move the chin from side to side. During the extraction of the third molar tooth, the buccal nerve may get involved by the local anesthesia, causing the temporary numbness of the cheek.